it's really a lot to deal with. First is, like you said, being exposed to those conditions that even kahit gaano tayo kahirap sa Pilipinas, iba pa rin yung makikita mo dun sa ibang bansa. And then, the fact of leaving behind the project, that's also very different. Like removing yourself from the situation and actually believing that it will continue. I'm not there, but it's still the same project. It's still the same thing. For me, that's one of the bigger part for it. More than actually being exposed is leaving behind the teams that I worked with. To be honest, Serbia for me was quite heavy because I was really exposed to so many things, listening to so many people go through that very arduous, perilous journey, bringing their kids, bringing their babies. So it was very heavy for me emotionally. What I normally do is once I come home, I really take a break from everybody. I stay in the house for like 3-4 weeks, minimally going out. I'm an introvert by nature. So I try to rebuild myself by being quiet and being with myself and being enjoying the things around me without going to other people. That's actually how I deal with it. I try to process it by myself for weeks. And trying to also tell yourself that as a humanitarian worker, you cannot solve the problem. Nobody can solve this crisis, the European migration. What you can only do is put stones on top of each other. We live for how many years, we are productive for how many years. The problems will stay for decades and centuries. What we can only do is put our stone, and hopefully someone will put their stone on top of ours. Make sure that we reach what we have to reach, or what we want to reach.